Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, we had an opportunity to go check out the sinister side of Comic-Con, and that being the Scarefest weekend in Lexington, Kentucky, at the Central Bank Center attached to the Rump Arena. This event took place October 21st through the 23rd, 2022. We had an opportunity to talk to a couple guests and some vendors. So, spook on, folks, and check out some of the people we spoke with. And if you wish to check out Scarefest in the future, it is scarefestweekend.com.
Now go do that voodoo that you do so well!
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here as part of Scarefest weekend in Lexington, Kentucky. And obviously, as part of this highlight film, we wanted to get some fan interaction. And luckily, before the show started here on day three, met Jason here. And Jason, are you first and foremost, how have you been enjoying the show? You've been here all weekend or?
I've been here since Friday morning when it started. It's been exciting. It's been absolutely wonderful.
Obviously, you know, especially with Comic-Cons or Horror-Cons, things like that. You know, the different things like this, the themed shows.
Oh, I work 5, 6, 7 shows a year, and yeah. Scarefest is the horror show to go to.
Right on. Yes, we've been saying that the whole weekend. You'll see that, and obviously folks of the con circuit are aware of Scarefest. But what I was going to ask was, because obviously with the Comic-Cons, the Horror-Cons, all that fun stuff, a lot of people like to, I guess it's cosplay now and costumes and the different things. And what attracted me, I saw your mask sitting at your table. Mm-hmm. You were just sitting, waiting for the show to start, relaxing. So my main question for you, sir, is what would you say your costume is? Is it based off somebody or is it just something you, hey, let me design?
All pure imagination.
Okay.
It's all created, come up by me. Since I made my scarecrow, I wanted it to be authentic. I hung it in the garden for a year to let it set and rot so it get the age weather look to it.
I was going to say, I got to ask the teeth here. Is that real wood or what's
real wood splinters?
Folks, you see on the video, this is pretty. And now, the other thing is, and you mentioned this as I was setting up here to take this part. You were adjusting so it can move when you talk. So can you talk the mechanical side of things that you to make this work for your mask? What did you do?
Learned a little bit from puppetry, the way that they move through the lips and stuff like that. I made a bottom plate to go underneath it so it reached my jaw. So that way when I talk.
You get there.
And then just two rubber bands attached to the side here. Give it that elasticity so it'll shut back.
And obviously, you're from the area, correct?
Sir? Knoxville.
Okay. So, excuse me for being dumb or naive to this. Okay. This is my final question. But, first part of that being, would you consider this region of where we're at in Lexington, Kentucky, part of the Bible Belt? Or what part of the country would you say? The South, Mid-South, more Bible Belt? What would you say this is?
I'd say you're right, teetering right on the edge of that frayed line of the belt, you'd say.
Okay.
Because there's so much more leaning towards the other way than there is towards the Bible Belt.
Okay. And the reason I'm asking that is I like to use the phrase, and I know you would be of age when I saw you without the mask, and I mean this respectfully,
right,
that in my neck of the woods of the Philadelphia Northeast and stuff, we like to, or me personally, like to MacGyver shit.
Yeah.
And MacGyver folks, obviously our fan base is smart to the entertainment business, is the original show from the late 80s, early 90s, excuse me. But I like to MacGyver shit in terms of I don't have the thousands of dollars to maybe make a project or something for the show work. But let's MacGyver and make the best out of the situation to get the best product out there. And would you say you've done that with your costume here?
Oh, very much so. I have. The only thing that's been bought with this costume was the overalls and the base that goes underneath this. All this other stuff was either sourced from my farm, sourced from the woods, or sourced from garbage cans. Because the skin on this thing is pallet plastic wrap. The teeth, it's wood chips. It's got paper mache on it. And this stuff, that's all the pieces behind me, is all wood.
Are we able to show that piece, or is that connected to you? We might as well.
It's all connected. In.
Okay, yeah, then don't fuck with it then. But... And I can say that, right? Yeah, we're fucking with it. No, don't fuck with it. But so yeah, you would definitely fall into our category of MacGyver and shit. And what can we do to make the best thing possible for the situation? And I appreciate that. You obviously put the time and the effort into it. So enjoy day 3 of the show. Oh, you know what? As a fan, you're here as a fan, obviously. Were you here to meet any of the celebrity guests? And if so, who were you looking forward to seeing?
Pumpkinhead.
Lance Hendrickson. Did you talk to Brian as well?
Brian's the one I was here to meet. Lance, I got to meet him. You know, but Brian's the one that played Pumpkinhead. He's the one I wanted to meet because all the special effects and the makeup and the costume. I wanted to ask him about what all it took to get into all that.
Exactly. And it's, you know, it's, there's a form of MacGyver and shit there too with film. Obviously, our fan base would know Stanley Winston was part of the effects and the makeup and all that stuff.
Yes.
And some of those films, whether it be The Terrifier, which is hot on the market now, Terrifier 2, I should say,
yeah,
or a Pumpkinhead for when that film was made and all, where it wasn't a $500 million movie project, but they made it for pennies on a dollar. But they made it look like the good ones. They make it look like they spent more money than they did.
All Full Moon projects and stuff like that. The Puppet Master series and stuff like that. They were based off of ideas that they had MacGyver and get these creatures together. And then they wound up making films off of stuff that they just threw together to make these creatures out.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Make things work, pennies on a dollar to get what you want accomplished. I don't care if, like you said, you're a farmer. Or you're making a movie, or, you know, but last question, because the door's about to open. You said you're a farmer.
Yes, sir.
So being a farmer by trade, and that's what you do in this neck of the woods, pardon the pun. What kind of farm are you? Because obviously you got the dairy farms, you got the way you grow your food, you got this, you got different styles. So what is your...
I'm a goat farmer.
Okay. Now, obviously, I'm not familiar with goat farmers. Obviously, I know goats, folks. But what do you guys do with your farm with the goats? And
we raise them basically as pets, and I won't sell them for meat, but we raise them up for milk goats.
Okay.
I have 44 kids running around my yard, and whenever I take them, you know, 2 times a day, take them down, we milk them, we sell milk off, which makes soap, cheese, all kinds of stuff, anything you make from milk.
Awesome.
And
because like I said, everybody does different things and has different specialties within their farm. And
I also take them and use them for like petting zoos, and I'll take them to cons and use them for shows and shoots and things like that.
Awesome. So Sir, thank you so much. Enjoy day three of the show.
Well, thank you. Thank you for interviewing me. I appreciate it.
I appreciate the few minutes you spent with me.
Well, thank you. Everybody come see Scarefest.
Yes, if you're in the area, it's a once-a-year show, but they were obviously doing something right when you're in year 14. So
it's getting bigger every year. This year's their biggest year that they've had. And I mean, you know, we're falling after COVID and they're getting bigger still. Come see us.
Yeah, come. And I can say I'm not one to kiss ass, folks. You all know that who listen to the show and all that. But I can say everybody I've met, whether it be even though you're from Tennessee and just people from the region in Lexington here, everybody's been awesome to deal with. Very friendly. That's Southern hospitality for right. Sure. Hey, what can we do to help you? Just, you know, good quality people. If you're going to come visit someplace, Lexington and Tennessee, and this neck of the woods is a good place to come visit, folks.
Come on in, sit down, and get creepy with us.
Yes, I like that. That's a good way to end, sir. Thank you again. Visiting a new vendor friend here at Scarefest in Lexington, Kentucky here. And we are here in booth 315 with Beanstalk LLC. For formal introductions, who are we here with?
So I am Kara. I'm the starter of Beanstalk LLC.
I'm Alex, the assistant of Beanstalk LLC. Nice to meet you.
Well, in your defense, Kara has put you over more, so there's more to just being an assistant. So.
Yeah, and he has a lot of his own stuff, too.
Yes. But. So, now you got to get your own credit as well, sir.
Sounds great.
But
most salon life for her today. I'm sorry.
What's that?
He's mostly just here to help me today. But
okay.
Yeah.
So, obviously, with your products, first and foremost, what do you do? How long you've been doing it? All that stuff.
So I kind of like Beanstalk has definitely developed over the last 2 years. I started in 2020 and it was just kind of a hobby because I was at that point I was in college and everybody was just kind of struggling through the pandemic and I was like needed a little extra side money. And I was like, you know what? I do art and I make things, so I'm going to make earrings. And so the earrings was really the first thing that I started doing. And then as time progressed, I started making stickers and then I started adding crystals into my inventory. So nowadays I kind of think of Beanstalk as like mystic and modern stuff for magical humans.
Corey Ireland, please return to the merch booth for a missing item.
Obviously,
Corey Ireland, please return to the merch booth 2 years or so.
Yep.
Is this your first time?
Yes, we've never been to Scarefest as patrons or vendors, and we've actually never been to, like, any cons as a business. I've been to Comic-Con as an individual. That's it. That's the only one.
And
being this is your first show and everything, and not having anything to have a gut feeling on per se.
Right, right.
But I'm a proponent of gut feelings, and but also having that based off experience.
Yeah.
What has this weekend been for you so far? How would you rank it?
I mean, it's really cool just to see, like, all the different costumes. Like, that's been my favorite part, just the experience in general, just seeing how many unique individuals pass by. I was not expecting as many people to be dressed up. I mean, people are just showcasing their talents, which is really, really cool to see all the costumes. But from a business standpoint, it's been super fun. I mean, it's been pretty good. We've had fun. I don't know. It's been great to also network with other businesses. There's a lot of very talented artists and businesses here. I've met so many very kind, nice people that just, I hope those connections continue to last because they're awesome.
And that's kind of why we wanted to include some of the vendors in our highlight video here.
Yeah.
Because we are Crazy Train Radio. It's for the fans, by the fans, and we respect the everyday man and woman like yourselves, because not everything is corporate America. So I'm not knocking corporate America, but there are more independent male and female businesses like yourselves and a lot of the vendors here.
Yeah,
I mean, keep things going at these shows and just in general.
Yeah, for sure. And I will say, like, corporations, I know it's convenient sometimes, but when you shop from a small business, I mean, you're really impacting someone's life. And I will guarantee that every small business, they're probably doing a little happy dance every time you buy from them. And big corporations don't do that.
So obviously we're going to have links and stuff to your stuff online.
Awesome.
But on this part of the video, as we wrap talking with you, where would you suggest people, if they weren't here at Scarefest, to find you to see if there's something they like?
Our next event is going to be Dickens Christmas Festival at the Henry County, Kentucky Renaissance Fair. And if you can't make it to that, definitely come out to the main Kentucky Renaissance Fair next summer. It runs weekends, June through July. We'll be there, and he'll have some really cool throwing knives and things, and I'll have my crystals and my earrings. So that'll be a really awesome event.
Is there a spot online people can look at what you do as well?
Yes, of course. You can go to shop@beanstalk.com. That's where you can find me. I'm also on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok as Beanstalk Studio.
Well, as Kara had said, we want to give you a little love too. How about for your knives and everything that you do? Is there a spot for them to check out?
My LLC is still a new startup, so I don't have a lot of an online presence. For the most part, I just go to shows and festivals with Kara and Beanstalk.
Yeah, so definitely come to the Renaissance Fair, because we're going to have lots of good stuff there.
So if you guys come out and see them in person or whatever, even online, ask Kara. I'm sure you can put him in touch.
Oh, yeah, for sure. I got the hookup for him.
Yeah. Feel free to ask. But folks, again, support these independent artists, the small businesses, everything else that we'd like to say. Support, whether it's the independent musicians, the independent businesses such as yourself, because they are a bigger cog in the wheel, as I say, compared to corporate.
Yeah.
And I'm not corporate. Thank you so much for
Thank
taking a couple
so
minutes
much.
To and best of luck with the rest of the show.
Thank you so much.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, I want to introduce you to Mr. Jeff I from the Killer's Card Game. He is going to be our, I should say, one of our newer sponsors, but also he is one of the first folks we are going to be talking to and part of this highlight film of Scarefest in Lexington, Kentucky, which between me and Jeff, he's a former Philadelphia area guy, but now in the Midwest. Between the two of us, we have more teeth than most people in the area. And he appreciates the humor because we've been at it all morning with that. So first and foremost, Jeff, and obviously we'll have you on a formal episode to break down the game and everything else as part of the introduction as a new sponsor and all. But here at the con, Killer's Card Game, what can you tell me, and can we get a synopsis and whatnot? What is the brand and everything else that you're promoting here at the convention?
Okay, so Killer's Card Game is a RPG-style card game, kind of like a cross between D&D and Magic the Gathering, all with true crime figures. So we got Jeffrey Dahmer, we've got Ted Bundy, we have some organized crime figures. We also have Lady Killers, we've got Cults as one of our expansions, and we've got a World of Serial Killers expansion. So we really cover the whole genre of real-life, true-to-life killers. The basic idea of the game is you get a stable of five killers. Your goal is to get 10 kills or be the last killer standing. So you have to abduct and kill your victims. You got to avoid the police, and you got to fuck over as many of the other players as possible to win the game.
Now, obviously, and for those who are here at the con, and they'll be seeing this post-con, but I know you are doing a special live game here at this show.
Yeah.
So how is that different compared to the normal game?
So, you know, the normal game is a tabletop game. You're sitting down with cards. You're playing that. The live game here that we're doing and debuting it here, you actually get a lanyard, and you're walking around trying to find other people. So you have three different categories. You've got killers, villagers, and police. So the killers are trying to kill the villagers or the cops. The villagers are trying to survive or help arrest the killers. And the cops are just going around trying to arrest the killers. So everybody earns points for whatever they do. They can get bonus points. And whoever has the highest point total at the end of the day gets a prize. Whoever has the highest point totals in each category by the end of the weekend gets a special prize pack. So, yeah, lots of fun going around the convention hunting other people down.
Exactly. Something besides the obviously spending with vendors and autographs and all that stuff.
Yeah.
I like that it's a little something different that you can do while you're here. And final question for this, and like I said, we'll have you on the actual show to go more in depth with stuff, and because we were swapping stories, I wrote in with Jeff this morning. But what we can tell publicly, I'll just say that based on our conversation that we were talking, I thought it was a fun conversation so far, and many more to come with Jeff. But is there a real life story that you can talk about publicly that you enjoyed trying to incorporate into the game?
Yeah, I grew up right outside of Philly, right? I grew up in the middle of all kinds of true crime. My family has been involved in all kinds of wild shit. So from a young age, I was really around it all my life. So it's always been a huge interest of mine, and I've always loved designing games. So for me, it was just a natural fit to put the two things together, something that I really enjoy, and really trying to broaden people's awareness, because I think it's important, like, if we're going to remain safe and do the things that we need to do and keep each other aware of the people around us, you got to know who the fuck is around you. And, you know, our game has over 300 killers in it currently. You know, they're everywhere. They just caught two new serial killers in California last week. Right? These people are around us all the time. And the more aware you are, the more you understand the psychology behind it, the better equipped you are to handle those situations. So I really created the game because of that. because I wanted people to understand that. I wanted people to have an awareness of what goes on around us all the time.
And full disclosure, as I wrap for Best Fortune anyway, and thank you again for coming on board with Crazy Train. But that was kind of part of the discussion we were having this morning coming in here, in terms of just based on the area we are from in the Northeast, we have a sixth sense of being more aware of our surroundings compared to most places in the country, in the world even.
Yeah.
And it's, like I like to say, it's our bullshit sniffer we have.
But, you know, what's funny to me is, like, growing up in the area that we grew up in, there's a certain look that you have to have that lets people know, like, I don't want to really fuck around with that guy.
Yeah.
And so, like, you know, over the years, I've softened a bunch because, you know, I do this shit now, and I got to be personable. I got to talk to people. I got to smile. But if I go back to Philly and I walk around, the mean face is on, and you got to make sure everybody stays a good distance from you, because you never know who's going to pull some crazy shit.
Like our part of that conversation we were having, just because we're in different environments, that Northeast attitude is still there.
Always right under the surface, yeah. Baby.
And it pops up when we need to. But obviously, for folks seeing the video, and we'll see and hear on commercials and everything else with the show. But in essence of this video, where can people go to check out the game, whether it be social media, website, all that stuff?
So the easiest way to find us is to go to our Linktree. So it's Linktree/KillersTCG. That will get you to everything that we have, our social media, our website, our Etsy page that has our clothing line on it. All of that shit is on there. That is the easiest way to find us.
So I'm going to have a link as you're saying that, in a nice little graphic look at, make it look presentable, folks. So Jeff, have a good rest of your show today. I know you're doing a panel this afternoon as of this morning when we're talking. So
yeah,
have a killer time.
Yes, I had everything. Everything works. So I got my my PowerPoint ready to go, baby.
There you go.
In Lexington, Kentucky again with Crazy Train Radio on the road again. But this is our first real con that we're visiting, talking to vendors, fans, interacting with guests from the show in our 10-year history. I found a couple of our core cosplayers, I guess you would say, would be the term.
Yep.
Well, first and foremost, thank you ladies for taking a moment to say hello. What's up? Would you mind introducing yourselves? And
I'm Kim. I go by Kim as Possible Cosplay.
And I'm Mary. I go by M. Poppins Cosplay.
Okay, so since you say you have that, are you guys on social media with what we do with the...
Yep. Okay. Yep, those are our tag names on Instagram and TikTok.
Well, that's good to know. So obviously I wanted to ask you guys briefly, since you took a moment out of your time to say hello and such. what has been your Scarefest experience? What's the weekend like? And was there any other celebrity guests that you were looking to see? What? Tell me about your weekend.
It's my first time coming to Scarefest. We decided to go for a vendor booth this year, so we set up our cosplays, a backdrop, and we've been entertaining people with our group of friends, but we've also been experienced the con.
We did some photo shoots yesterday.
We did the photo ops with Jason and Freddie.
Yeah, and the Jeeper Creeper truck.
Nice. Yeah. So overall, what would you say, because you said you came in as a vendor as well,
yeah,
and everything. So overall, how would you say your weekend has been?
It's been great, honestly. I've had a good time. Our merchandise has been selling pretty well. So definitely I'm going to come back next year.
Well, obviously I want to respect your time and everything else and not hold you all day. But where can people find your merchandise and your handles as well, again, on social media?
So we're on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok. And here at Scarefest, we're at booth number 216.
Okay. So look for them under our handles if you want here at Scarefest. Thank you so much for the time. Enjoy the rest of your Sunday. And mazel tov to you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we are back here again at Scarefest for our highlight video for our On the Road series. And we are visiting with some friends we connected with prior to coming to Kentucky here from our Northeast home base. Our friends here at Country Line Graphics. So first and foremost, who are we speaking with and what can you tell us a little bit about Country Line Graphics?
My name is Amy. This is my husband, Nathan. The business is County Line Graphics. We do specialty plates, and we do car coasters and different things. We can do logos and any kind of work that you would basically have a graphic designer put together. And we actually do graphic design work, too, and we do a lot of that for people. We can take them and put them on tumblers, and like I said, the car coasters, lots of plates, anything. My husband's actually getting ready to put lots of plates together right now. We do this business out of our home, and we've been doing it about 3 or 4 years, and we've been doing shows longer than that, doing different various things. This is something we got into, and we really like it because we're really able to reach all kinds of customers across the world doing special products.
Now, obviously, I'm going to put a little description at the end of the video of everybody, but also for this portion where we're chatting off, going to put a logo and all, which you were nice enough to send over, and but where can people find what you do if they weren't here at Scarefest?
Right. If you were not here at Scarefest, or even if you are and you're watching this, you know, on a general replay, you can reach out to us on Facebook. That information I did send over, so it will be linked. And you can also look it up by looking up County Line Graphics Tennessee. That will pull it up. And we also have an Etsy shop with the same logo on it and everything. And you'll be able to pull it up. Primarily, our license plates are what sells better online, but we can ship any of our products. And so all you have to do is reach out to us through message. There's a message either way. And you can be like, you know, hey, we'd like to get something done. And we can do basically pictures back and forth via email or through the messaging system so you get what you want.
Now, obviously, last question for you, because I'm going to have some pictures here of stuff you got out on the tables and all, just to show what kind of products you do do. But with all the different creative things that you have and done over the years, for the 3-4 years you've been running things, off the top of your head, what would you say is probably the most fun piece you've done that stands out? I know it's a bold question there.
It is a hard one. We do so many license plates for various people we know, and a lot of people have killer logo graphics that are theirs because they spend, you know, time because it honors their business and really what they're about. So when we have the option to put that on something, I think that's the best part of our job, no matter if it's a license plate or if it's something else. So I think the most rewarding part is being able to take something that somebody else has that they want to capture in a piece and put it together.
Awesome.
You know, that's just a special memory that they're always going to have. So, and you know, and seeing people's reactions. That's the best
part. Well, folks, we want you to, if you feel the need and like what you see, whether stuff I show you here from the show or what you see on the Etsy and Facebook and all that other stuff, feel free to reach out. You have the contact information, as you will see on the logos, and also the end of the show or the video episode. Feel free to reach out, see if something can be done. Give them a shout out. Support these small businesses because they help make this machine go for the bigger shows.
And we've had a great time. This has been fun.
Beautiful. Thank you.
Thank you. Here's a card if you need it.
Yes, I will.
If anything, you know, gets misplaced there. Here's you a carbon copy.
Yes. Yeah, that's why I figured I'd, because I saw the machine. Yeah, so what are you making there?
I'm making a custom license plate for a customer that sent me in our booth. Stop. I came around yesterday and come back today and actually made the order.
Now, how long of a process is that? What's the machine you're using there?
Well, we have a transformation screen down here. They actually print the image, and we have to transfer it to the plate with our heat press. From the time we design it to the time we get handed to the customer, usually about 10 minutes.
Oh, okay, nice.
If it's a real complex design, maybe about 30 minutes. And then we're really backed up again. That's the law depending on that. But that's the general.
But as we said, you'll be able to check out more of their products through the social media and the Etsy and all that fun stuff, folks.
And these have the UV protection on them and all that, you know. We do recommend the little clear protector plate if you buy anywhere to go with it, but you don't have to have them. I have one on mine. Looks still looking good as it is when I put it on there 4 years ago.
Looks like he's frying hotcakes there.
Yep, it's done.
You got the steam. Steamer Slimer there.
The lady said they call their car the Echo. So.
There you go. The Echo 1. And it turned out beautiful.
Yeah.